One of the nice things about being out of area and then coming back in is, again, having some interesting packages waiting for you. So, let's go ahead and add a little more to the Schmidix and the titanium cup. And we will go to the Fox Hanks company. It's called Fox Hanks. Not much else on the packaging. Unique, handmade, limited edition on the stamp. It's nice that there is a, I actually kind of enjoy the texture and experience of the plain brown wrapper package. Some folks will get it and some people won't. But this is kind of interesting, even though this isn't completely plain. There is a stamp on the wrapping. The it comes with a what appears to be a wood tag with a handwritten note of thanks, which is always nice from a vendor or provider. I'm going to go ahead and fire up this Daruma. It's a nice Maduro smoke and kind of like a small Toro package. And yeah, sets off this Schmidix quite nicely. Now, getting back to the Fox Hanks. Handkerchiefs, something that I've worn in the pockets of suits from time to time. For some time, it's been something that is considered a gentleman's accessory and almost required during different periods of time in history. Fashion comes and goes and ebbs and flows, but you know, good style is always appreciated by certain elements of culture and society. And so we come to this, and this is not your standard handkerchief company that makes the standard, you know, white or just solid color handkerchief. These are companies, and there's several companies that are doing this now, that are making patterns that are double, the handkerchief itself is double-sided in some cases, and also provides for different textures. And in this particular grouping, we've got a nice, looks like it's black. There is a subtle, almost marbling of the black side of this handkerchief. There's some blue stitching with very, it really sets it off with a particular pattern. Almost looks like a wave or an electric wave. The opposite side is a maroon or subdued red with the same color stitching on that side. It has a tag as well, Fox Hanks, single-sided on the tag. Not necessarily absolutely required, but you know, obviously helping to set off the distinctive flair of this particular company. I don't know the person who makes these. I would imagine you know, they're putting a lot of style and flair into their handkerchiefs. Here we have something of a diamond pattern with a subdued gray on the opposite side. Nothing particularly distinctive about this side or the diamond pattern side as far as unusual stitching, but again, kind of a nice pattern. Now we've got an olive and slightly gold or tan color. It looks like a leaf pattern. Again, with the Fox Hanks logo or the tag. The texture appears to be cotton. And again, thinner than what I would have expected it to be. With what I was told, I was expecting something a little thicker. Now, in this particular piece, it is a little thicker. This is a little heavier gauge or a little maybe that's not the right term for fabric, but a heavier texture fabric. And this does have some type of interconnected X's around the piping with black on the reverse side. And again, with the same black stitching that's on the front. Now we have something similar to what we just looked at. Lighter weight material than the black and white. But nonetheless, nice distinctive pattern. Something to really kind of set off your pocket for a sports jacket or blazer. Quite frankly, perhaps even a suit, depending on the fabric and texture of the suit. Now, we'll go ahead and go to the second package. Again, still from Fox Hanks. And we've got four handkerchiefs here, and these are heavier fabric. And you know, something to really kind of set off. Heck, even your pocket. You could wear some of this stuff in the pocket of a pair of jeans. I really like to highlight the pattern of the borders. This has a double border stitched through. There is no stitching through the center of the handkerchief, but not absolutely necessary either. I mean, this is not, you know, in handling this is not easily coming apart. I had to really kind of pinch into that to get it to separate in the center. Another very distinctive pattern. The fabric, again, heavier than some of those lighter fabrics that were shown earlier. And continuing with the tag. The tags have, it seems like they have different colors for the tags depending on what they want to match it with. This is something with a little bit of almost like a Western pattern. Now that I'm looking at it, it almost looks, quite frankly, almost looks like something you'd see on upholstery. So, but, and again, heavier material too. Something, you know, for outdoors if you're gonna be, you know, out in the wintertime, what have you. And then this particular piece, has a bit of a, almost like a herringbone texture. I like the blue coupled with that bright green that really sets this off, reversing to gray. Now, these handkerchiefs are at about 10.5 inches by approximately 10.5 inches on this. That seems to be, this is just under 11 inches by under 11 inches, or strike that. Just under 11 inches, and again, just under 11 inches. I didn't see that quite properly. The handkerchiefs appear to range at anywhere from about 10.5 inches by 10.5 inches by almost just under 11 inches in dimension. This lighter weight fabric looks about the same. So, you know, again, just under 11 inches on most of these. I'm going to be rotating these in as it's possible. There's going to be some environments where you're just not going to want to wear something like this. It just won't be compatible with what a man or a gentleman, if you want to go to that extreme, would wear. This one's at about 11 inches by 11 inches. But it's always nice to have just a little accent. And, you know, my grandfather would have said that every gentleman should carry a handkerchief with him at all times. You know, as a lot of us know, things like handkerchiefs or bandanas can be used for a variety of tasks, not just blowing your nose or wiping your face, but you know, you can use it in certain first aid circumstances or situations, and it's just a nice touch if you can even use it to, you know, wipe your sunglass lens, depending on the fabric material, and again, as first aid or even just to carry something. So it looks like we've got a whole battery of possibilities here, and I like the fact that it switches from pattern to a solid color, and in some cases, some enhanced stitching, which really kind of sets off the entire piece. So I'm going to get back to this Toro Schmidix. I may even do a couple of pass arounds on these to see how some people can handle them.